Hi, this is Kerry again with Best of Us Investors. A little different surroundings here. We don't have any power here in Birmingham, Alabama, at least in the neighborhood I live in. So I'm sitting next to a window to do this video. I was thinking about not doing a video, but I think I had a very important question that I wanted to ask you and explore with you, and that is, who owns the internet? Who owns it? We know who owns the data. We know the data is owned by Apple, Google, Amazon, Microsoft, Facebook. We know who owns the data, but who owns the infrastructure? Who owns and makes the internet available to you? So I've been doing quite a bit of research on it, and I think I've got the answer, and I think it's important for you to understand who owns the internet and how it's going to affect the investments that you make in the future and why you have to own Amazon, Google, Microsoft, and Facebook. And if you don't, you're going to lose out on a big opportunity to make a lot of money. Now, as I said, I don't have power, so my computer doesn't work. So we're going to kind of skip over that intro that we do regularly on the video where I tell you I'm not your financial advisor and I put it in words so I'm protecting my, and you can't sue me and say, he told me to do that and he's my financial. No, I'm not your financial advisor. But let's talk then about who owns the internet and why that's important to you. The first thing you need to know that the internet is based basically data. It's the data that people have collected from you over the last 40 years, and they've stored it in the cloud. Well, who is that? I think I mentioned their names just a little bit ago. That's Amazon, that's Microsoft, that's Facebook, and that's Apple. If you don't own them, you don't own the people who own the data. And the data, along with artificial intelligence, is what is going to drive the internet in the future. We know it's going to drive the metaverse. But did you know that once you get outside the boundaries of the United States, the internet is run on a highway? That highway is fiber optic cable. It's a cable that sometimes is no bigger than your garden hose that has fiber optics in it. It's a very sensitive cable, but it runs under the oceans from the Atlantic Ocean to Europe and then to Asia, and then from the Pacific Ocean over to China and also to Asia. And are you aware there's 8,000 miles of that cable laying on the ocean floor. And there are ships that are used to get that across the ocean. And who do you think now owns those ships? Not owns the ships, but is paying for that all to be done? Yeah, it's Amazon, Google, and Facebook. So if you don't own them, you don't own the infrastructure. How important is that? Well, let's assume that Amazon owned all the highways in the United States. How important would that be to their business? How important would that be to UPS and FedEx? So if you don't own Amazon and they own the highways, you don't own e-commerce. So that's something that we have to be aware of. Are you aware that the four stocks I talked to, Amazon, Microsoft, Fiber, Facebook, and Google, before 2012, only accounted for 10% of the use of fiber optics. Today, they account for 66%. Who owned it before 2012? It was the governments and the telecommunication industry. But since then, these four stocks, Amazon, Microsoft, Facebook, and Google, have taken over the ownership. They actually spent $90 billion in 2020 alone to put that cable across the ocean so that you could and they could control the internet. Now, they partner to do this, except Google. Google is kind of standalone and says, no, we're not sharing our cable with anybody. And that's important because if you own the cable and a ship breaks it or a fish eats it, you're out of business. And that happens 200 times a year. So it becomes important that these people own what they need. They're owning it. They're then what one they once they own it, what are they going to do with it? They're going to rent it. They're going to rent it to other people who want to communicate with the emerging markets of this world. You already have more than one flat screen TV, but the people in India don't. The people in Africa and South America don't. The people in Turkey don't. So that's where the future lies for e-commerce. That's where all the new searches are going to come for Google. So it's important to own the highways of the internet. If you don't own them, if you don't control them, you're at someone else's mercy. So if you don't own Amazon, Microsoft, Facebook, and Google, you don't own the infrastructure of the internet. Now, this is going to become 10 times more important than it is today as we move into the metaverse. As we move into the metaverse, we're going to escalate the use of the internet, some say, by tenfold. Thus, the cables across, the fiber optics across the oceans become gold, become the power structure of the future of the internet, and most important, the future of the metaverse. So if anybody asks you, who are the leaders in the metaverse, remember this: Amazon, Microsoft, Facebook, and Google, because they own the highways that it, the future development of the internet is going to be laid on. And that's the fiber optic cable. Look at this picture here. The red lines are the lines that are owned by the four. The black lines, which you got to look a little bit closer, are those that are owned by the governments and the telecommunication companies. Now, the four stocks or companies are very smart. They're also allowing the telecommunication companies to use their cables so that they basically avoid some restrictions that telecommunications fall under so that governments don't come and try to take them away from them or say, wait, you've got a monopoly on the internet. They're doing this right so as to protect themselves. They're also sharing, as I said, the use of their cables with Amazon is sharing with Microsoft and Facebook so that if their cable breaks, they have somewhere else to go. Now, Google's approaching it different. They are saying what's mine is mine, what's yours is yours. And that's kind of, as those of us who know something about netlists, that's kind of Google's attitude. We'll take what we want and we'll work by ourselves. We don't believe sharing is fun. That's Google's attitude. But Amazon, Microsoft, and Facebook, they believe what you and I believed as kids. Sharing's fun. You did believe that, didn't you? That's what your mother told you. Sharing's fun, particularly with your brothers and sisters. But in the world of fiber optics, Amazon, Microsoft, and Facebook believe sharing's fun. Google doesn't buy into it. Okay, so that's what's important right now. And that's why I think it's of utmost importance that you own the companies that own not only the data, not only the platforms to sell the goods, to give you the search that makes the internet something that you are so dependent upon, you now need to own them for another reason. And that is they own the infrastructure. And they are no one's competing with them for it. They're basically taking it. It's important today, but it is going to be paramount as we move into the metaverse. So again, if anyone asks you, what are the most important metaverse stocks? You now know the answer. And if you're like me, you're gonna start dollar cost averaging into these stocks every month. I don't care what the price is. You pick a day when your paycheck comes in and you send some money to buy stock in Amazon, Microsoft, and Facebook, and Google. You're looking for percentage growth. And I think it's fair to say you will get 35% annualized growth on these stocks for the next 10 years. And then I would ask you, who's going to replace them? They own the data. They own the processing farms. And now they own the infrastructure. And remember who told you this first. My name is Kerry Grinkmar. I'm the host of Best of Us Investors. I'm going to expand this channel to bring you more presenters who give you new and fresh ideas. And if you want to be a part of this, you know how to do it. Go to bestofusinvestors.com, give me your name and your email address, and I'll send you a link to our Discord, and you can become a member of our tribe, and you can become someone who makes good financial decisions, learns how to keep more of what you make by understanding the tax code, and then builds family wealth so that you make a difference in the time you're on this earth, that your ancestors say, damn, I'm so glad my grandpa understood the stock market and bought those people who own the infrastructure of the internet. And if you've already forgot their names, it's Amazon, Microsoft, Facebook, and Google. I'm sure you can find them. I'll talk to you again tomorrow, if we get power.